Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to share with you how to add a location to Teams and Outlook using the new function called room list. Room list are a logical grouping. So we have a building called building A and we have a building called building B which has multiple meeting rooms in those buildings. So using the room list we can logically group meeting rooms in building A and building B. When a user try to schedule the meeting and the user has the option to select the location based on the building or the grouping that he had done the room list function. So in this tutorial I'm going to create two room lists and add these two meeting rooms and demonstrate how this can be done using Exchange Online PowerShell. We'll first have to connect to Exchange Online PowerShell using Exchange Online. It's a principal name. I think I have already logged in. Let's give it a minute. Alright. We can use XO mailbox to check whether our connection is working. If we get the response, okay, we are connected. So the first thing that we have to do is we have to create the mailboxes, room mailboxes. So I have two mailboxes already created, meeting room 1 and meeting room 2, which is going to building B. So we'll create the building B room list and we'll add these two meeting rooms. So we have to create a distribution group. So each room mailbox is a designated distribution group for that task. New distribution. Give a name. Using this parameter, it will become a room list. Building B is created. We'll add the meeting rooms to this room list. Meeting room 1 and meeting room 2.
the B room list, we have two meeting rooms added. Now we'll check the building name. Building A room list is also created. We'll add the members rooms. This should be building A, and this should be changed. Conference room 2. Check the group members. Okay, distribution group is there. Check the member in building A. Right, now we get two meeting rooms listed on building A, and two meeting rooms are listed on building B. So once this is done, it'll take up to 24 hours to make the changes. If you make any changes to this configuration, it will take that time to reflect to the teams, since I have done this earlier. It should be listed down here, right? Let's see. Okay, here we go. So we have the building A. The meeting rooms are listed down there, and building B. We have the meeting rooms as well. Right, and that's it, and thank you for watching.